She said, Mom, when I grow up, I'm going to raise money for St. Jude. And she wrote a speech. And I'm going to ask people to support the hospital, and this is what I'm going to say. Hayley was in the fourth grade. She was 10 years old, and she was into everything.
I loved spending time with my friends, watching Bruce Lee movies because we were all really into martial arts.
She was doing taekwondo, and she started complaining about her knee hurting.
So I took some ibuprofen, felt a little bit better, but then it started coming back and got worse.
We were leaving school and she was kind of limping, kind of dragging her leg and limping. And I was like, what's the matter? And she said, my knee hurts.
At that point, my mom looked at my leg and saw about an orange-sized tumor above my left knee.
And I just knew something serious was wrong. The doctor took one kind of look at it. She said, you need to go have an x-ray. Right now.
And I'll never forget, she immediately brought us into her office, showed us the x-ray and said, this is bone cancer, osteosarcoma.
That was the first time we heard the word cancer. I just felt so helpless.
And I just said, I don't want to die, because everyone I had known at age 10 who had cancer had passed away. And I thought cancer was a death sentence.
My disease is called osteosarcoma, and it's a bone cancer. It's very serious. If you don't catch it fast, it spreads.
It wasn't until we went to St. Jude a few days later when I actually started feeling hope. When we walked in the doors of St. Jude, we walked up to the front desk, and I'll never forget, my mom tried to say my name and just burst into tears. The receptionist came from around the desk and gave my mom a big hug.
She goes, it's gonna be okay. She said, you're part of the St. Jude family now, and we're gonna take care of her, and we're gonna take care of you too. And that's when I knew I was at the right spot.
And honestly, truer words were never spoken. We really became a family.
The tumor's both inside the bone and grows out of the bone.
So her tumor was in the end of the thigh bone, just above the knee joint, all the way to the knee joint, so it involved the growth plate. Biggest growth plate in the leg is the one right above the knee, which we had to resect. So we put in a fairly new prosthesis called the Phoenix, which allowed expansion of the prosthesis to keep the legs equal until she reached skeletal maturity.
It would expand my leg about 2 centimeters in 30 seconds, which ultimately saved me several surgeries and just gave me so much more quality of life. Without having to go through surgery after surgery, the prosthesis could expand every time I needed to grow.
I'm trying to lift my leg like my right leg, but I can't do that yet because my muscle isn't strong enough.
It's her enthusiasm, her determination that we saw, the way she rehabbed, the way she fought her disease. It really is, it's a fight. And she took the fight to the osteosarcoma and she won.
St. Jude made it so that we really didn't have to worry about hospital bills and those kinds of things, and we could just focus on having time with her because nothing was guaranteed.
When you're dealing with a catastrophic illness like this, it is something where you have to try to live in the present, and you have to enjoy those moments because that might be all you have.
My dad died of kidney cancer 2 years ago, and it was so difficult watching from the sidelines. And I remember whenever I was going through treatment, just really feeling like I was the one going through it. But whenever I saw him suffer and just feeling so helpless, I realized what a hard experience it was for the families.
I just loved you.
Cancer made me who I am. But not just cancer, St. Jude. I knew from when I was in treatment that all I wanted to do was work at St. Jude. So when I got my dream job, it was the happiest moment of my life. And it's the happiest thing that's ever happened to me. It's truly the biggest honor of my life, getting to work with these kids.
What's your move?
St. Jude gave me my child's life and they kept her spirit.
St. Jude saves lives. I mean, not only did they save my life, but getting to work here, I see these brave kiddos. I wrote this speech when I was 10 because I wanted to grow up and raise money for St. Jude. And I told my mom, I was like, this is what I'm gonna say. They saved my leg and they saved my life. For me, St. Jude didn't feel like a cancer hospital, but a place where I was surrounded by love.